Michael Cohen got off easy. 3 years, it's pretty good. He's got to be happy about that. What do we
nobody is happy about going to jail.
He knew what he was looking
at. But it's a lot less time than the government wanted and a lot less time than we all thought he would get. Look, I've sentenced over 1,000 people in my career, and I've heard things defendants say. Sentencing today is essentially a mathematical function. You're checking boxes. You're complying with guidelines. Obviously, there's some room for deviation. And Judge Pauly, the judge in this case, gave Michael Cohen a substantial benefit. It's interesting. Remember, he was prosecuted
because
by
cooperation.
Correct. He was prosecuted by two offices. He was prosecuted by the special counsel in D.C. They wanted him to get no jail time. And he was prosecuted by the U.S. attorneys here in New York. They wanted him to get 4 years. Judge Pauly gave him three. But a very, very telling statement came out of the judge's mouth yesterday after he read all the documents and heard all the arguments from the government, prosecutors in D.C., prosecutors in New York, Michael Cohen and his lawyers. And that was about the president. The judge finding that the president ordered and paid for Michael Cohen to commit a crime. That is very telling.
What crime?
The intentional deception and failure to report campaign payments.
But so, Donald Trump has said that that was not a campaign violation because it wasn't involving the campaign. It was a damage control payment.
Unfortunately, the president wasn't in the courtroom, and the people who were, the federal prosecutors who had a statement from David Pecker, the guy that owns the
National Enquirer,
said it was for the campaign. The prosecutor said it was for the campaign. Michael Cohen said it was for the campaign. The president wasn't there. Maybe he should have had lawyers there. So if you make an honest mistake in failing to report something, or if you take $100,000 and you're only supposed to take $2,500, you can correct that by returning the money, paying a fine, and correcting the report. If you do this as part of a scheme to hide it, then it's not a civil wrong, then it's a crime. That's what the judge found yesterday.
Well, if, like, for example, Reverend Wright is speaking out, making President Obama, candidate Obama, look bad, and someone walks up to Reverend Wright and says, hey, could you stop making the president, the senator look bad? He's running for president. But what does that have to do with the campaign? But yet it is how that might influence how I vote.
That would not be a campaign.
So this is no difference. This is a negative story the president went out because he's running for president.
I understand the president's argument. Unfortunately, the court and the prosecutors who work for the president disagree with him.
Yeah, but they went after John Edwards for essentially the same idea because there was a money paid to a woman who he had had an affair with and had a child. That went to court, that went to trial, and he was found not guilty.
The John Edwards case actually hurts the president because John Edwards' lawyers made a motion to dismiss the indictment saying it's not a crime. And the judge published an opinion saying why it's a crime. Now, the jury didn't believe the government and believed John Edwards. But the fact of the matter is any scheme to defraud the government by failing to report what must be reported is a crime, unless it's an honest mistake, in which
judge,
case it's not a scheme.
Does he have to serve all 3 years?
No, he'll have to serve 85%. But if the Criminal Justice Reform Act that the president wants, that Democrats want, that Republicans want, from Cory Booker to Rand Paul, passes, one-third of his time will be removed.
And he'll
be
2 years.
He'll be out in about a year and 9 months.
All right. Judge, thank you very much.
Pleasure.
Be able to practice law again?
No, I doubt he'll ever practice law again.
Well, who would
Brian,
hire
some
him?
People say he never really practiced law.
I've heard that.
And he owes a lot of money in restitution, right?
He does.
A couple of million.